Over lunch break, and we got to see him.
Let me see if I can get up close.
Oh, wow. Wait, where is he? There he is. Oh, hello there.
Hello there.
Columbia, Missouri. I will play for you This Is the Day by Fred Hammond.
Hi, kids. I have Brother IDK on video call. Hi, Brother IDK. Hi. Hi. What's wrong? I don't know. I don't know why you didn't tell me we were dressing up Christmassy. But it's all right. I'm a scientist. I'll figure it out. I got my fern over there. It's got bulbs on it. Got my robe. My robe over there. I can use that. And got a few decorations on the wall. Yeah, I can figure it out.
Well, today's story is from our beginner Sabbath school lesson, and it will be about the birth of Jesus.
What's wrong? I don't know. I don't know why you're talking about that. And not about my latest inventions.
What latest invention?
You know, the Invisimask that I made for Tony, since he don't have ears.
You know, I think that was a really convenient invention.
I don't know why you say that.
Well, since it's invisible, we don't know whether you made it or not.
Well, gee, that's the things I get. We're making something invisible. Well, anyway, what about thank you meter? That worked. That discovered who you were going to say thank you to. I knew you were going to say thank you to Sister Fail.
I have to give it to you. That did work. Hey, but tell me, how did you make it?
Well, to be quite honest, I saw the light and I bought it. And then when I saw the things that were done in Oaktown, I pressed the button. And then the light came on and that's how I knew we need to thank somebody.
What? So you pressed the button to make the light go on? That's not an invention.
Well, I don't know why you had to be so technical. Bought the light. I looked at the Oaktown stuff and I pressed the button. And what's the first letter in invention? I invented the thank you meter.
Well, kids, up next, our Sabbath school lesson. The person who invented potato chips didn't make the potato. The person who invented ice cream, he didn't make the ice. So I don't see why the thank you meter can't be something I made. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're rolling.
Verse 9. Your unfailing love, oh Lord, is as vast as the heavens.
Okay.
You know what that means, right? His love for us is bigger than a dinosaur. That's huge.
I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love. I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have the faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I am nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be sealed. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. But when I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Our lesson today is on the birth of Jesus. There was a king who lived at the time that Joseph and Mary lived. He had ordered that everyone had to go to their place of birth to pay taxes. So Joseph and Mary had to travel to Bethlehem, which is the birthplace of Joseph. They did not travel by a car, nor by a plane. Mary had to ride on a donkey. Mary and Joseph had to travel a very long way. They finally arrived at their destination, and Joseph went to the inn and asked the innkeeper for a room. He said,
"We have come a long way, and my wife is about to have a baby."
"I am so very sorry, but there is no more room at the inn. However, there is a manger with nice soft hay that would make a great bed for your baby."
"Thank you."
After a while, baby Jesus was born. There were shepherds out on the hillside with their sheep resting. And all of a sudden, an angel appeared.
"Greetings! I bring you good news. Jesus Christ, the Savior, has been born. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive. Let every heart prepare him. snake.
The shepherds said to one another, "We must go to the city and look for the baby." The shepherds knelt down beside baby Jesus. They came to pray.
The shepherds came to pray, came to pray, came to pray. When little baby Jesus was born, the shepherds came to pray, came to pray, came to pray. When little baby Jesus was born.
We must remember, boys and girls, to thank God for sending His Son to be our Savior and love us. And we should always show love to others as well.
I love you, Lord.
I will love thee all of my strength, Psalms 18:1. Dear Jesus, thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you for protecting me and for loving me. Thank you for food and shelter and bless all the little boys and girls. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Well, kids, as you can see, Jesus showed His love for us by becoming a human being, even a baby. How many of you want to show your love like Jesus? Me too. Thank you, Sister Taylor and friends, for that awesome Sabbath school lesson. Well, during Children's Story, we talked about how words are good, but showing someone something makes it easier to understand. So let's test that out some more. Some of your neighbors in Oaktown are about to describe an animal to you, and you have to guess what animal it is. Are you ready? Okay, here we go.
Hi, my name is Mackenzie. My animal runs really fast and it has spots. What is it? It is a cheetah.
My animal lives in the ocean, has a tough shell, and can live up to 120 years. What am I? A turtle.
Hi, my name is Mitch. My animal has a big trunk and it has a big body. What is that animal? An elephant.
I'm the fastest man on earth. I have big teeth and I have spots. What am I? A cheetah.
My animal is very tall, has a long neck, and has brown spots. What am I? That's right, a giraffe.
My animal has long, sharp ears. It hops. It's brown, but it's usually gray. And it has lots of fur, and it's fluffy. And it has a black nose. It is a bunny!
The animal I pick has sharp claws, eats leaves, and lives in Australia. What is it? A koala.
My animal wiggles. It is slimy. It has wings. And it drags itself on the floor. What is it? It's a worm!
Hi, guys. I'm thinking of an animal that's really big. And it has tiny arms. And its teeth are as big as a banana. And it's a carnivore. What is it? Do you know? It's a Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Were you able to guess any of the animals based on the words the kids used to describe them? Well, if you were able to figure them out, I'm sure it wasn't easy. And because of sin, it wasn't easy for us to figure out how great God is or how loving God is just based on words. And that's why the Word became human. And that's why Jesus became a human being. And that's why Jesus became a baby. Aren't you glad that God didn't just tell us His love, but showed us His love through Jesus? Me too. Well, let's watch some more of our Christmas program 2019.
and see our children's choir sing a song about how thrilled Mary and Joseph were to have baby Jesus.
Hi.
Hello.
Are you Mary and Joseph?
Yes.
What did you do when Jesus was born?
We celebrated God became a man,
and we got to be the parents.
That's called for a celebration.
Awesome job, Children's Choir. And thank you, Sister Raphael, for writing that song. And thank you to our choir director, Angela Baptiste, and our assistant, Janine Vidal. Well, it's time for our giveaway, our theme song, and then our prayer. And I pick Ryan S. Congratulations, you will get your gift this coming week.
Some
dog and that going on blows.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
The gift God gave to save us all.
The gift God gave to save us all.
I'll tell you what's better than the holidays.
I'll tell you what's better than the holidays.
I'll tell you what's better than a Christmas tree.
I'll tell you what's better than a Christmas tree.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
The gift God gave to save us all.
The gift God gave to save us all.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
The gift God gave to save us all.
The gift God gave to save us all.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
I'll tell you what's better than a dozen gifts.
The gift God gave to save us all.
The gift God gave to save us all.
Thank you, Sister Raphael. And thank you, Anaya, for that song. Let's pray. Dear Father, thank you that for you, words were not enough. You gave us your son, even as a baby. And so we got to see your love in person, and we celebrate that this season. Thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen.